Okay, so for this question, we have two queries, just like a table of persons and a table of the tools that person owns. How can I make a list like that? Right, like with the person and the tools that they own, right? So say I already have a table for persons. Let me make a table for tools. Then you could have a person ID. You could have an ID for the tools also, but let's assume for the moment that it's just person and tool. Then and you would have a ID number. The first field is the primary key, right? First person has a ladder and has a hammer. Second person has a screwdriver and a hammer and a wrench. The third person has a wrench and a ladder. Okay, so I'll save that. In access. That was in the database in Microsoft Access. And then I'm just going to go to ODBC to that Access database and refresh it. There's the database. Okay, it's refreshed. To get the new table, the table of tools. And we can go to Framework Manager. Here's the database, at the database level, create a query subject called TBL tools. It's a data source from the database. This database we just created. Here it is, it works. Finish. We got the table. Create a query at the business layer. Take those fields, validate, okay, test, okay, define a relationship, person ID to person ID. One person can have zero or more tools. Okay. And make a shortcut to that tool query subject, copy it to the presentation layer. Change the name to tools. Go to your package. Check the definition. Yeah, it's there. Publish that package. Okay, the package is published. You can close Framework Manager. Go to Cognos Express or Cognos. Punch Report Studio. Okay, create a new query list. Okay. Here's a person table, right? There's a person ID. There's the first name. There's the last name. Right. Here's a tool table. There's the tool. You could put the person ID there if you wanted also. See, it's called person ID 1 because it's the second field with the same name. Okay, you could sort on, sort and group on person ID, right? If you run that, looks like this, right? Okay, then let's make a header. So you go to structure, headers and footers, list headers and footers, and I want okay, first you have to click on that field and do a group by. That's the blue and yellow icon. Now it's a group by. Now you can go to structure, headers and footers, list headers and footers, right? I want a person ID header and a person ID footer. Okay, there it is. You can run it. So there it is. There's a person ID header in dark blue, right? And the person ID header, you want the person name, right? So, do the unlock. The first name in there, the last name in there. Go to toolbox, text item. Put a space in between the two fields. Put a space in between the other two fields. Right, run it again. Then it looks like that. And you don't need this first name here anymore. So you can do edit, cut. Don't need this last name anymore. You can do edit, cut. Do the lock symbol here. Edit, cut. Right. And you don't even really need this here. Edit. Cut, right? And here for the tools, that's the tool, right? You might not need the header. Let's say you don't need the header. Do an edit cut. Okay, you might not need that grand total. Do an edit cut. Run it again. There you got your report. Clint Eastwood has one. He's person ID number 1. He has a hammer and a ladder. Kyle Eastwood is person number 2. He has a hammer, a screwdriver, and a wrench. Al Eastwood is person number 3. He has a ladder and a wrench. These other people don't have any tools, so they don't have any tools listed under their name. So that's the report, and thanks.